Hello, beautiful people. Welcome back to my channel. My name is Kaya for any of you that are new. In today's video, I am going to be installing another wig. Nothing new. Slight. Today's wig comes from Ebony Line. I do want to say thank you to Ebony Line for sending me this wig today, y'all. I am reviewing this wig from Zuri Sis. It is in the style Limo, and I have it in the color 99J. It's one of their drawstring wigs, is how I would describe it. Okay, vacuum bag is what it says, the vacuum bag units. So if you guys are interested in seeing me install this, as well as what I think about the unit, then continue to watch. Before I jump into the video, make sure you go ahead and subscribe to my channel, hit the notification bell, as well as follow me on my socials, which will be right here on the screen and in my description bar below. Let's go. Alright guys, so jumping into the installation of this unit. Taking it straight out of the packaging, I just wanted to show you guys the construction of this unit, which seems to be the biggest part or play in this unit and your reasoning of deciding to purchase it. So the unit has a stretchy cap as well as an elastic band, and it says that it is a vacuum bag in your form of security. So this unit does not come with adjustable straps. In replacement of that, they have given you a vacuum bag. There are also combs in it, which are more so to the sides of your nape area. They'll be on the left and right side instead of in the middle. And then, so I put the wig on and I didn't do anything to the elastic band, which is also adjustable. I just put it on how it was. And the wig is actually pretty secure before I even got to touch the vacuum bag area. So I would say that Zuri Sis, they did definitely nail that very well. The elastic band and the vacuum bag definitely make this wig feel super duper secure. So I did go in and try to pull the vacuum bag portion just a little bit to see if it was going to make any bit of a difference, but it was already secure to my head enough without it. But I do think it definitely adds a bit more of security. And once I put the unit on, you guys, there wasn't really much work to do to the unit. It's a middle part wig. I did do some baby hairs around the front part of what would be visible. You know, I just want to see if it was going to make much of a difference in how it looked, if it was going to look any more natural. And I like it with the baby hairs more than without them. It does come with some, but I think I added a little bit more into it. That definitely took the longest with this installation process. This unit says that it's safe for you to use heat on, and it also comes in other colors. It says that you can wash and care for the unit as well. I've actually never tried washing a synthetic unit, but maybe I should try that one day. I didn't have any problems as far as it shedding or tangling. It was pretty much straightforward, one that you can put on and just mess with the front and then you're good to go. I definitely love the color. 99J always shows out and it's a really pretty color. I do wish the unit would have been a little bit longer, but it is still an appropriate and cute length. I just would have preferred a little bit more length in this. I think it would have taken this unit over the top for sure had it been a little bit longer. They do have this form of a unit in other styles. They have the ones Mal and Pina. One being more of a bob look, and then the other is basically looking the same as this one, except it's in straight form. I got the one that is more so wavy. So if you guys don't like the wavy look, you do have the option of trying this constructed wig in a straighter form or in a bob look. But that's all I have to report about this unit. I definitely think you guys should try it if you're interested in it. I'll have Ebony Line's link below for you to check it out. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye guys.